nice. You never know if it could change your life. Take a chance, you're neither wrong or right. You never know if you don't roll them dice.
Happy holidays, Matt.
We're saying happy holidays again. I love it.
We're saying happy holidays, saying, listen, to you. The war on Christmas is over and Christmas has lost. I'm sorry, everybody. It's there's only holidays now. Christmas no longer exists. It's been.
I wish you wouldn't bring this up. You know I served in the second war on Christmas. I lost a lot of good friends at the Battle of Gumdrop Hill.
Listen, Matt's got really bad PTSD post-tinsel disorder.
Stress disorder, yeah.
No, I listen. I'm sorry for bringing it up. We're not going to talk about Gumdrop Hill or the Candy Cane Massacre or any of the other horrors of our long running and never ending war on Christmas.
Storming the Kringle Castle was a rough one.
So something none of us are ever like to forget. Hello, everyone. This is Dungeon Master of None.
I'm Dungeon Master Matt.
And I'm Dungeon Master Rob. And for your bonus episode for November.
Rob's going to tell us how his novel's going.
It's going great, Matt. It's going very well. We're talking about holidays. And yeah. Calendars. This is a really great suggestion from one of our listeners in the Discord. If you haven't joined that, by the way, please come. It's not just for patrons. It's for anybody who wants to come and hang out. And there's some pretty cool ideas in there. But we've done a lot of world building in the past, like a lot of world building. And I don't want to say that we have like run out of things to talk about, but we hit all like the big, like major, you know, factions, countries, pantheons, that sort of thing. There's a lot more to do, but I was sort of like running out of ideas. And then there was the suggestion for doing holidays, calendars, which is, it's from Drew R. Thank you, Drew R., for your suggestion. And I love this idea because this is so interesting to me. And I also think that having holidays, having festivals and celebrations and so on and so forth in your world gives it some texture. It's not necessarily critical, right, to the narrative, or it's not as important as like coinage necessarily to the actual playing of a TTRPG, but it's a really like excellent bit of flavor. It also does a really good job of measuring and sort of delineating time in a much easier way than like forcing your players to like memorize your fake calendar that you made up. You know, it's 10 days to the Harvest Festival, or it's, you know, 20 days to the, you know, Founders Day celebration, or it's, you know, next month it's going to be, you know, Lord Eustace's, you know, Crown Day, something like that. Like these to me, I think are really good ways to provide, to indicate the passage of time without requiring your players to, again, memorize a whole new list of days and dates and the names of months and things, or keep track of the lunar cycle or something.
Right. You want to give your world texture without giving your players math homework, right?
Right.
It's useful in like a couple ways. Like, it gives your world texture, right? You know, your players can be like, oh, what year is it? And you know, right? And if your campaign spans months, years, decades, there you go. You have a calendar. It can also like give individual sessions texture, right? What time of year is it, right? And it also is like a convenient way to like, if you want something happening, right? Mm-hmm. In so many of our campaigns, players get really into where their characters inhabit, their relationships with them, each other, and with NPCs. And if you ever want to like throw in something that isn't like the next quest, or like give a backdrop to something that's happening. Oh, it's a holiday. It's a celebration that's going on, right? I was just rewatching Cowboy Bebop, so I could rewatch I could watch for the first time the live action version that everyone's shitting on, that I'm sure is adequate or something. But I was watching the Cowboy Bebop the movie, Knocking on Heaven's Door. Ooh. And it's so much cooler because it takes place in like Mars's like Halloween pumpkin fest or something, right? And there's a stupid Macy's parade. Amazing, right?
Well, and think about this is exactly the point I was going to make. Think about how many cool moments in movies or television shows or books occur during a parade, during the fireworks at the 4th of July or New Year's Eve, during Carnival or something like that. These are such great set pieces to distinguish your sessions. Like, even if your players are not participating right in the holiday, around them there's a bunch of people in masks, or there's fireworks going off, or there's a parade.
How could we ever enjoy Jackie Chan and Owen Wilson's Shanghai Nights?
That's exactly what I was thinking of.
The Queen Victoria's Jubilee.
That's right. That's right. That's also the culminating moment of The Great Mouse Detective is Queen Victoria's Diamond Jubilee. I mean,
those are going on at the same time. The mice are fighting and Jackie Chan shoots that one guy with a firework or something.
Exactly.
But this is the problem with Jackie Chan's like movies that are like made in like not the Hong Kong studio system, is like, instead of him having this cool epic showdown with the villain, they just get like shot or something.
Right. Yeah. Well, that it's sucks. America. You can't beat somebody with your fists. It has to involve
just like take a firework to the chest and then explode over the River Thames.
Yeah, it's not sufficiently dramatic if you just beat them up. But this is a great, again, it makes for a great climactic moment. It also adds drama and intrigue. Again, so many celebrations involve masks or costumes, like trying to hunt down a fleeing fugitive or identify a villain when everybody is wearing a mask. I mean, that's good, easy stuff. And you can be as sort of, I think what we're going to talk about, we're going to, you know, talk about some of these specifically and how to build them and how to use them. But you can be as creative or as generic as you want to be with your celebrations, right? There's in the real world a lot of, you know, they all involve eating and drinking. Almost every festival and celebration you will ever encounter is going to involve eating and drinking. Lots of them involve costumes. Many of them involve gifts. You know, you can use this to sort of ground your world and your campaign, or to indicate that things are a little bit weirder. You can go a little further afield.
A lot of our holidays involve the celebration of some kind of magic. Spirits are loose on this day. This is the day that so-and-so, you know, came back from the dead, you know, but not as a zombie. And in fantasy worlds, right, you can have magically auspicious days, right, where maybe there's a planar interaction, or undead are more powerful. Magic is more powerful. Magic is less powerful.
This is a great one. Again, in the real world, it's very common for many holidays to take place at a time when the veil is thin.